I'm Alex Roy, automotive journalist, here today to talk about thermal cameras with Stuart Clapper from Veoneer.
Hello, Alex.
And Paul Clayton from FLIR.
Hello.
And a lot of companies are saying that because they already have radar and LiDAR and camera, that the systems are safe or safer. Why do we need thermal cameras?
The fact is, to have the very safest cars on the road, you need redundant technology. So just having one or two different sensors is probably not enough. You really need other sensors. And that's why thermal has a very important place in the future.
In 2016, the Highway Safety Association shared the statistic that 6,000 people were killed, of which 75% of those happened at night. And if you have thermal cameras in your car, you kind of really start to impact that 75% of fatalities because you can see them and you can adapt appropriately.
So in the Tempe, Arizona crash, which took place with the Ubers, when the Uber didn't spot Elaine Hertzberg crossing the road,
right?
Like, what happened there? Because they had radar, they had camera,
right?
And they had LiDAR, and yet the vehicle didn't stop.
Right. Typically, if you want to break down these systems, they break down into two areas. You have a LiDAR and radar that typically give you ranging, and then a visible camera that typically does your classification and understanding of that. The visible camera that was in that car saw something and classified it as unclassified, and then a vehicle, and then bicycle, and then person when it was too late. The thermal camera would have seen 2 to 4x that range and would have absolutely classified it as a person because the temperature difference at night, the person pops out like crazy on a thermal camera. We actually estimate we would have had about a 10-second window to say, that's a person, stop the car. And at 44 miles an hour, with the car was traveling, 10 seconds is plenty of time to avoid that person.
The real question is, why aren't thermal cameras standard on every vehicle today? I've had one for 15 years. I had to install it myself.
It started off that thermal cameras were quite expensive, and we've brought the price down. And it's getting to a point now where companies are starting to realize it may be the necessary technology to make autonomous driving safe.
And so how much have the units diminished in size and power consumption? How much better are they today?
So, you know, they started out of military technology, and they were so big you couldn't put it in the trunk of a vehicle. And we took this million-dollar technology and brought it down in cost and in size so it became affordable for automotive application.
To give an example, the latest cameras that we're working on that can go into ADAS or autonomous driving are about the size of a large sugar cube. And within that sugar cube size camera, you're talking about something that has a much better resolution and much, much better differentiation.
And the pricing has come down. I mean, I think the system today costs a tenth.
Oh, yeah.
Or even a 15th of what they used to cost.
And in automotive volumes, it'll come down much, much further because scale drives price down.
So how much further can thermal see than other sensors in the suite?
Usually 100 yards down the road, you can detect if there's a pedestrian or an animal on the road. And we can alert the driver of the pedestrian or the animal on the road, and the driver can react.
And in the future, in the next generation system that we're currently working on together, actually, we have 4x the resolution of the new system, and you'll be able to see twice that distance and adapt even better.
How long before thermal cameras become as ubiquitous a safety tech as everything else that's already in the ADAS suites you sell?
We've really got to get the word out. I do not want another Tesla or Uber accident to happen. And if we can get the word out so people will start using thermal to improve the safety of the systems, that's what we've got to do. And that's what our mission is. That's why we gave away our thermal data set. That's why we're promoting thermal as much as we possibly can in the market space, so we can help save lives.